Hey there, measurement ladies and gentlemen. Do you know that now you can customize your standard reports in GA4? Let's explore this feature together. We reached the most exciting part of the whole standard report section, in my opinion. And in this lesson, we will discover how you can customize your reports. And yet this is possible within standard reports, so it shows you how much flexibility GA4 has to offer. Okay, so let's have a look. I will go to my traffic acquisition report, for example, and this is where you can see the visualization and this classical table. I cannot say this visualization is super helpful, and some people might find it to be even distracting, and you can simply hide it. Yeah, this is possible. And by the way, I'm using my test property because the customization feature is not available in the demo account. So we do not have permission to customize their reports. This is why you should do it in your property where you have access. So here in the top right corner, you have customize report. And if you click here, you can see charts. And this is where you can simply hide those charts. Let's say I don't want to see those. I simply want to have this table. Okay, so this is my table and we can view the metrics here, but where is my conversion rate? I can see event count, engagement rate, conversions, but what about conversion rate? It is available in GA4, so this metric is present, but you cannot view it directly here in this report, for example. You have to add it manually. And this is again in this customize report section. Here you can also see dimensions and metrics. And this is where you can add dimensions and metrics you would love to analyze. So let's click metrics and here add metric. I should look for my conversion rate. And here we have session conversion rate. And let me also add my user conversion rate. So this is how conversion rate is calculated in GA4. You might be a bit confused, but let me explain those metrics. So user conversion rate shows you the percentage of users who converted, whereas session conversion rate shows you the percentage of sessions in which any conversion took place. So this is the main difference. And here you can also change the placement of your metrics. So you can decide in which way you want to have them displayed. So let's say I want to move it here next to my sessions. Okay, and let's click apply. And here we go. We can see session conversion rate and user conversion rate. So if you want to save this one, you would have to click save and it will save changes to current report. Now let's click save. And now you will see that our report is modified. Change is saved, and if we go back, here we go. So we can see just the table, and we also have session conversion rate and user conversion rate available. Okay, let's move to the next example. I want to include a team of marketers. So I want to involve them, and I want them to participate in my project. But they don't want to play with the report's configuration. They simply need the report. And my team needs the landing pages report. It's not available in GA4. You cannot find it here as well. So what could we do? We could also create this one. So we would have to go to library. And this is where you can create a new report. So I would click create new report. Create detail report. You remember that each section is comprised of an overview report with the card layout and a detail report with the classical table that we have. So let's select this one. And this should be pages and screens. And here we go. You can see we have our typical report. Let's go to dimensions. And let's remove those dimensions here. And we want to have landing pages. So this dimension is available here, landing page. And let's click apply. Awesome. So now you can see your landing pages and you would have to save it Let's provide the name, landing pages. You could also add the description and click save. And you can see that it is saved in library. So let's go back. And if we check our engagement, I already have, because it was created before, I already forgot about it, but it's not enough to create a report. You would have to add it to the current collection. So this is my life cycle. You would have to click edit collection, and let me remove this one because it's an old one. And you would have to look for your landing pages report, and you would simply put it here. And you can also choose the position where you would love to place this one. This is great. And let's say I want to include publisher ads, for example, or in-app purchases to my monetization. So you can put it here, or if you want to delete it, you can simply remove it, right? And then when you're ready with your changes, you would have to click save. And we should save changes to current collection, because if you save it as a new collection, you will get the new lifecycle collection. So it would be kind of doubled. So let's click save changes to current collection. And if we go back, here you can see engagement. And there should be my landing pages. So now your team of marketers can work with this one. So I think it's pretty cool. And you can play with standard reports. You can modify them. You can change their interface and make it comfortable. Let's say I want to get rid of this retention. Let's go back to library. And if we want to remove something, yeah, because we added this, but now I want to remove retention, we would click edit collection again. And here we have retention, and let me remove it. And I would click save again, save changes to current collection. And if we go back here, you can see my retention is gone because I'm not using that report that much and I don't need it. So this is a nice feature, I would say. It was not available in Universal Analytics, but GA4 offers you so much flexibility. And you can modify your standard reports and make them as comfortable as possible for your work processes. I hope this made you like GA4 a bit more than before. And if you want to check other GA4 videos, you can find them right here. Please give us a thumbs up and see you next time. Happy measuring!